Hi, I'm Jonathan Bird, and welcome to my world. This is a tooth from a sperm whale, the largest toothed animal on the planet. The mouth that this tooth came from is so big that it could swallow a person in one bite. Can you imagine what it would be like to swim with a sperm whale? I'm gonna give it a try.
My adventure begins with a trip to the tropical island of Dominica in the Eastern Caribbean Sea. Dominica is a lush mountainous island, the remains of an ancient volcano. The mountains are filled with dense tropical rainforest containing a variety of exotic animals. Large amounts of rainfall create hundreds of rivers and streams,
which creates dozens of picturesque waterfalls, just like this one.
Dominica is a beautiful place to visit, and the coral reefs are incredible. All kinds of colorful tropical fish live around the vibrant reefs, even the elusive seahorse. Dominica's mountainous terrain continues underwater. The bottom drops off quickly, and the water is extremely deep.
In fact, here only a mile from shore, the water is more than 3,000 feet deep.
This deep water attracts the ocean's largest toothed predator, the sperm whale. The classic story Moby Dick is about a malevolent sperm whale out for vengeance. But in real life, sperm whales are not mean at all. In fact, they're downright shy.
Whales are mammals just like people. That means they have lungs and they breathe air. So when a whale dives, just like a person, it has to hold its breath.
But unlike people, sperm whales dive thousands of feet deep to hunt for food. Sperm whales can't see anything down in the deep ocean because it's dark. They find food by echolocating. The whales make clicking sounds which bounce off objects and echo back to the whale. The whale listens to the echoes and it can tell how far away the object is. Sometimes it can tell how big it is and even what it is.
Finding whales is difficult, but there's one way we can find out if they're in the neighborhood of the boat, and that's with this. This is a hydrophone. It's an underwater microphone, and what we're going to do is put it in the water and try to listen for the sounds that the whales make. I can definitely hear some clicks in the distance, so there have to be some whales within about a mile of the boat. Now all we have to do is find them.
We set out to find the whales. Finding sperm whales takes patience.
We're looking for a spout on the horizon. They're really hard to see with sperm whales.
Our first encounter is not with sperm whales, but with dolphins. They love to ride the bow waves of boats. It's kind of like dolphin surfing. We drive around in circles and they seem to love the excitement. But finally, we have to get back to looking for whales.
There!
I spot a single sperm whale far from the boat, but as we approach, it dives out of sight. Not in the mood to play, I guess. Back to looking for whales. Suddenly, my luck changes, and a sperm whale pops up right next to the boat. If she allows our boat to approach, then maybe I'll try to swim with her.
This is probably a female, about 30 feet long, and she looks like she's just resting. Sperm whales like to rest between their dives because they dive very deep.
She seems pretty mellow, so I'm going into the water. I don't use scuba gear to swim with a whale because it's too bulky. I'm just gonna use my mask, fins, and snorkel. I jump in and start swimming towards the whale. I have to hope that the whale finds me interesting, because if she swims away, I can never keep up. The only way I can get close is if she wants me to. And it looks like she doesn't. But that's okay, because soon a whole pod of whales has come over to our boat for a look. I can just tell that these whales are curious. One calf in particular is taking a close look at us. If ever there was a time to get in the water, this is it. When I get in, there are whales all around me. The calf's mother notices me and turns towards me. Her 6-foot-long jaw is open and filled with teeth. Is she going to eat me? I'm not sure at first, but it looks more like a yawn than a threat. Not sure what to make of me, she turns and casually leads her calf away. But on my other side, another pair of whales have decided to come close for a look. I can't believe it, they're coming right over. I can tell they're investigating me because they're clicking me with their echolocation. I can feel the clicks pounding in my chest. They're incredibly loud. These whales are huge. I mean, each one's the size of a school bus, and they could be really dangerous if they wanted to be. But they don't. They're gentle and curious, and once they've satisfied their curiosity and gotten a good look at me, they just kind of swim away and go back to whatever it is they normally do.
That was incredible! Did you see how close I was?
My encounter with the sperm whales was probably one of the most incredible experiences in my life. As the sun sets on the horizon and we head back to shore, I can only wonder what the whales are doing deep down below me. For now, the mystery of the sperm whales' everyday life remains hidden in their deep blue world.